Hello students, welcome to the lecture series on financial market operations. We shall take up unit 2nd and deal with money market. Under money market, we shall deal with its intermediaries and associated instruments. We shall also discuss various provisions relating to money market and the subsidiaries which are associated with it. The learning objective of money market is to understand Indian money market and its structure as well as composition. We shall understand the working of acceptance house, discount house and call money markets and analyze the recent trends in Indian money market. So, overall after learning this, after going through this lecture, we will have a clear understanding from the structural aspect till the recent market trends of the Indian money market. We know that a financial system shall comprise of the 4 things: financial services, financial instruments, financial institutions and financial markets. So, money market is one of the components of the financial markets. So, where it is being falling, we need to understand it step by step. This is the financial system's depiction. First one is the financial institution. There can be regulatory institutions like RBI, SBI, central banks. There can be intermediaries like all other scheduled banks and non-scheduled banks, non-intermediaries services and other like cooperative banks or RRBs. Then there can be financial markets. Financial markets can be organized markets like the commercial banks. It can be unorganized market like the money lenders or the local money lenders or sahukar, which we call. Then there can be primary markets and secondary markets. Primary markets are those markets where the first time issue of shares or the public issue is being made by the company, or already existing company comes up with the new shares. So, where there is first time issue of the shares and the money flows from the public to the company, such place is known as primary market. Secondary market is a place where the already issued securities are being traded, that is buying and selling of the already issued securities is being made in the secondary market. So, when we go to the capital markets, they are the subparts of secondary markets. It is again another detailed aspect where financial instruments are being analyzed, that is financial instruments can be primary, secondary. They can be short term, they can be long term, medium term. Then financial services, which we have already dealt in our unit 1, that is merchant banking, mutual fund, venture capital, leasing, and it is not exhaustive list but the inclusive one dealing with various new services and product mix. So, this is the overall scenario of the financial system. Right now we have to deal with the money markets. So, under the financial markets, we need to analyze where we are falling, and we will continue our discussion on the aspect which is falling under the financial markets. So, we will have a small chunk of this diagram and let us analyze under financial systems where we go to the financial markets. Under organized sectors, there can be bankers and RBIs. Unorganized, we have already discussed, there can be local money lenders. Under primary market, first time issue of securities. Under secondary market, there can be 2 aspects: capital market and money market. Capital market is a market where long term investment is being dealt, where lending institutions are dealing with the long term securities is the capital market, and where the short term needs are being met out, these places are known as money market. So, our fund requirement is short term. Money market works on the principle of the liquidity, that is safety and liquidity are the prime focus of an investor in the money market. So, let us understand what do we mean by money market and what definitions have been given by various bodies. meaning of money market. It is being given by one of the scholars, Acroth. Money market is a collective name given to various firms and institutions that deals with various grades of near money. Near money is which can be transformed into the liquid assets, or where liquidity is being the prime factor, easily convertible securities. That is, any security which can be converted into money is near money. So, under money market, various firms and institution works, and they are collectively known as money market, dealing with the grades of the near money. This is the first aspect of the definition. Let us understand what RBI has given us the definition. The money market is a market for short term financial assets that are close substitute for money, that is what we call near money, facilitates the exchange of money for new financial claims in the primary market as also for financial claims already issued in secondary market. So, here a comprehensive definition is being given by RBI stating the role of money market, that it deals with the financial assets which are substitute of money. So, it is very clear that financial assets which are short term of nature are being dealt under the money market by various institutions. Now, let us highlight characteristics of money market. It involves in arrangement of short term funds, as its prime motive is a safe and liquid investment. So, in a way this is the parking place of the idle funds. Secondly, it is a tool for preparation of monetary policy and fiscal management, because they are dealing with the money aspect in the short term. It deals in high liquid instruments, as liquidity is prime focus of the money market. So, investment in money market can be for a year or less than a year. It can be for a one day transaction like call money transactions or notice money, which can be exceeding for a period of one day, and it can extend to 14 days investment like T bills or up to 3 months. So, there are various instruments dealing with the liquidity aspects under the money market which we need to understand. Fourthly, the players in this market are RBI and commercial banks and companies, because any market cannot work in vacuum. There needs to be certain bodies or players who need to perform the task. So, under money market, the major players are RBI, and that is the major dominating factor of money markets, as it is also dealing with the preparation of monetary policies and fiscal management. Then commercial banks and companies are also part of money market, because the prime objective here is the maintenance of liquidity. So, even RBI too needs to maintain the liquidities, the central banks need to maintain the liquidity in the form of SLR ratios and CRR ratios. So, this money market is going to play a major role in maintaining the liquidity and safety of the funds. And fifthly, that is self-explanatory, that it is being regulated by the RBI. RBI is the Reserve Bank of India, the apex body. Sixth, it tells about the trends in liquidity and interest rates. It provides fund at low transaction cost, because the gestation period is as low as 3 months to 6 months. It suits the requirement of borrowers for the short term funds. It encourages open market operations. So, these characteristics reveals that money market is a place where the financial institutions deals with financial assets to meet the short term requirement. The borrower takes the money for a short term period. Now, there are certain borrowers for short term funds in the money market, and they can be commercial banks, central government, state government, corporate sectors and local bodies. They might be needing the funds, short term funds, for certain objective, as we said that for meeting the CRR and SLR ratios, there can be need for the short term funds. So, basically the governmental sector is the borrower here who needs short term funds. Funds can be of long term also in the money market, that is for a period up to 1 year. And in that case, the borrowers can be central bank, commercial bank, saving banks, discount house, acceptance house, bill markets and bullion markets. There are certain terminologies like discounts house and acceptance houses, bill markets, which we will learn in detail in this very lecture only. Now, when we talk about Indian money market, there can be two sectors of Indian money market, that can be organized sector and unorganized sector. When we are dealing with the organized sector, there can be indigenous bankers or the RBI, which can be its main players. In the case of unorganized sectors, the local money lenders can be the players dealing with the instruments of money market, and the financial assets are being dealt with the money lenders. It's a different aspect that interest rates and other parameters would be on a higher side in case of unorganized sector. However, the accessibility to the funds might be much more easier. Now, elaborating the indigenous bankers, there can be various players such as RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. It is the apex body of the banking regulation in India. It can be the player of the money market. Then commercial banks and development banks, mutual funds and cooperative banks. They all can deal with the financial assets in the form of certain instruments which will be for short term period under money market. When we are dealing with commercial banks, there can be public sector banks as well as private sector banks. In case of public sector banks, SBI and its subsidiaries, all nationalized banks and regional rural bank can be the major players which will fall under the category of commercial banks. In the case of private sectors, all scheduled as well as non-scheduled banks, Indian banks and foreign banks shall be the major financial institutions in the Indian money market. Development banks are those banks which are being constituted for development of certain region. Their objective is for development of infrastructure facilities or for small scale sector or any specified sector. Such banks can be IDBI bank, IFCI bank and ICICI bank. These banks also are the major players in the case of money market, and they can fulfill the short term requirement of the funds in the case of money market. The next one is the mutual fund. Mutual funds can be private mutual funds, unit trust of India, foreign mutual funds and commercial bank mutual funds. And the last player would be the cooperative banks. There can be state cooperative banks and central cooperative banks. So under money market, we can assume that all those organizations dealing with the borrowing and lending of the money, they are the players of the money market. Now, let us highlight the instruments which are being used in the money market. The major instruments are treasury bills or T-bills. They can be issued for a period up to 30 days or 90 days. They are generally being issued at a value lesser than the face value and redeemed at face value. The difference of amount is the bonus or the main highlighting area of the treasury bills. That is the amount of interest which is being calculated. That's the working of T-bills. Then second is the commercial papers. Commercial papers are a form of unsecured short-term loans. They are being issued by the major financial institutions who have been registered for issuing commercial papers and complies with the guidelines which are being prescribed for issuing the commercial papers. These guidelines are in related to the size of the issue. The size of the issue should not be less than 25 lakhs. The net worth of the financial institutions who are issuing commercial paper should not be less than 5 crores. Then their current ratio should be maintained as 1.33:1. And their rating, that is credit rating, should be minimum up to P2 and A2 or from ICRA. So these can be issued at discounts or at a face value. So this is the working of the commercial papers which are being available under the money market. The goal of issuing such instruments is again safety and liquidity, parking place of the idle funds, and a very wise escape from the long term funds which are being blocked in the long term investments. Then the another is interbank call money. Call money is a short term investment for a period of 1 day, or it can exceed 1 day, and it can be considered as notice money. Repurchase options is also one of the very important instruments under money market and money market mutual funds. They are also short term funds and work almost similar to the mutual funds. Now coming to another very important aspect under money market, that is acceptance house. How does they work? What is its working and what basically they are dealing with? This is the prime focus of our discussion on the acceptance house. An acceptance house or a financial institution that accepts a bill of exchange. That means it is a financial institution basically, and it accepts bills of exchange. Bills of exchange, we know that they are being governed by a negotiable instrument act. Bills of exchange are transferable exchange bills which can be used for the meeting short term requirement of the fund. They can be discounted early. So again, under acceptance house, this is primarily dealing with bills of exchange which are being accepted. It primarily guarantees the payment of bills used to finance trade deals and goods in shipment. Its profit is the difference between discounted amount it guarantees to pay and the full amount of bill that it undertakes to collect from the original creditor. So obviously they will work on the profit, and profit is ascertained by difference of the amount guaranteed to pay and the full amount. Such arrangement helps in reducing the credit risk. So this is a basic assumption of working of the acceptance house. A concept similar to acceptance house is discount house. They are primarily operating in the UK. This concept we have imported from UK. A firm that buys, sells, discounts or negotiates bills of exchange or promissory notes is a discount house. This is generally performed on large scale with transactions that also include government bonds and treasury bills. In India, Discount and Finance House of India was set up, which work as a discount house. It was set up in April 1988 in pursuance of the recommendation of Working Group on Money Markets under the chairmanship of Mr. M. Vegul. The DFHI, that is Discount and Finance House of India, was set up jointly by RBI, PSP and financial institutions. The paid up capital was also being jointly contributed by these players, that is RBI, public sectors and financial institutions. The prime objective of discount house was providing liquidity to money market instruments, safe and risk free short term investment avenues to the institutions, and facilitates money market transactions. Because when the bills are being discounted at a period earlier for which the maturity is being held, so there is a easier availability of the money, and the liquid position of the cash is much more better. There is safe and risk free short term investment. The equity based risk is not at all being involved here, and of course it facilitates the money market transactions. The main functions of the discount house is discounts, rediscounts, purchase and sale T-bill, bill of exchange and commercial papers, plays an important role as lender, borrower in the interbank call money market, and it also works as promotional and advisory services in money market operations. Now, the next and the last important concept for our discussion is the call money market. Call money means money lent for one day, and notice money is the money lent for a period exceeding one day. So it is the call money market is that money market which is for short term and long term funds with maturity which may range from overnight to 1 year in India, including financial instruments that are deemed to be close substitute of money. So again, they are dealing with the near money, and here in India, the period of those instruments which are being dealt under call money market can be from overnight, that is 1 to 14 days, or it can extend to even 1 year in certain cases. So primarily, so majorly the instruments which are being used are the bills of exchange and T-bills or government bills under the call money markets. Now, why there is need of call money market? That we need instrument for lending money for one day. They are basically being used for the banks where there is shortage of funds. So bank borrows in this money market for the following purposes: to fill the gaps or temporary mismatch in funds, to meet CRR and SLR mandatory requirements, that is the banks are required to maintain a statutory ratio, and that statutory ratio can be maintained by having the adequate funds. As and when the funds are being inadequate or mismatched with the stipulated ratios, they can borrow in the call money market and meet out their requirement. So for such mechanism, call money markets come into existence. And to meet sudden demand of funds arising out of large outflow, in case of large outflow where liquidity is being on lower side, call money markets assistance can be taken to meet up these demands. Now students, we are summarizing our discussion on the money market. Money market is one of the important components of financial market. It is a segment of the secondary market. Secondary market is a place where the buying and selling of already issued securities in the primary market are being dealt with. So in the case of financial markets, there are organized, unorganized markets, primary and secondary markets, and there are two segments of secondary market. One is capital market and another is money market. Capital market meets the long term requirements of fund, and money market meets the short term requirement of fund. And the players under the money market can be organized players, that can be RBI and indigenous bankers, and under unorganized sector they can be money lenders. We have also dealt with the instruments which are being used in the money market, that can be treasury bills, bills of exchange, commercial papers, repurchase orders, repurchases and various such instruments. We have also learned in detail about the call money market, the discount house and acceptance house. With this, we are ending up our discussion on the money markets. Thank you.